I think I ought to warn you, we're off to Poetry Corner.
Now it's time for poetry with Miss Berryman. She's a very big poetry fan. Poetry Corner!
Okay, this is called I Saw My Teacher on Saturday. So, I saw my teacher on Saturday. I can't believe it's true. I saw her buying groceries like normal people do. She reached for the bread and turned around and then she caught my eye. She gave me a smile and said, "Hello." I thought that I would die. Hi, hello, Miss Berryman. I mumbled like a fool. I guess I thought that teacher types spent all their time at school. To make the situation worse, my mum was by my side. So many rows of jars and cans, so little room to hide. "Oh, please," I thought, "don't tell my mum what I did yesterday." I closed my eyes, held my breath, and hoped she'd go away. Some people think it's fine to let teachers walk about, but when it comes to Saturdays, they shouldn't let them out.
Poetry Corner!
I think I ought to warn you, we're off to Poetry Corner.
Now it's time for poetry with Miss Berryman. She's a very big poetry fan. Poetry Corner!
Okay, this one is called The Painted Lesson and it's by Trevor, Harvey. "What's that, dear?" asked the new teacher. It's my mummy," I replied. "But mums aren't green and orange. You really haven't tried. You don't just paint in splodges. You're old enough to know. You need to think before you work. Now have another go." She helped me draw two arms and legs and a face with a sickly smile, a rounded body, dark brown hair, and a hat. And then in a while, she stood back with her face bright pink. "Oh, that's so much better, don't you think?" But she turned white at 10 to 3 when an orange-green blob collected me. Hi, Mum!
Poetry Corner!
I think I ought to warn you, we're off to Poetry Corner.
Now it's time for poetry with Miss Berryman.
I sat at home with my kittens. They're beautiful, cute and mini. One of them's called Ferguson and the other one is called Winnie. They love to hear my poems and the one that they hold dear is called The Owl and the Pussycat by a man named Edward Lear. But my kittens aren't quite pussycats because they're not quite fully grown. So I changed some words to make them fit for my kittens in my home. The owl and the pussycat went to sea in a beautiful pea green boat. They took some honey, plenty of money, wrapped up in a £5 note. The owl looked up at the stars above and sang to a small guitar. "Oh, lovely kitty, oh, kitty, my love, what a lovely kitty you are. You are, you are, what a lovely kitty you are." Pussy said to the owl, "You elegant fowl, how charmingly sweet you sing. Oh, let us be married, too long we have tarried. But what shall we do for a ring?" They sailed away for a year and a day to the land where the bong trees grow. And there in a wood, a piggywig stood with a ring at the end of his nose. His nose? His nose? With a ring at the end of his nose. "Dear pig, are you willing to sell for 1 shilling your ring?" said the piggy. "I will." So they took it away and were married the next day by the turkey who lives on the hill. They dined on mince and slices of quince and ate with a runcible spoon. And hand in hand, on the edge of the sand, they danced by the light of the moon. The moon, the moon. They danced by the light of the moon. Say goodbye. See you later. Oh. See you.
I think I ought to warn you, we're off to Poetry Corner.
Some things that you catch aren't nice, like colds, coughs and sneezes. But what about infectious smiles? They're my kind of diseases. The poem that I chose today explores this very notion, how smiles can help to brighten your day. They're magic, like a potion. So this poem is called Infectious Smiles and it's by a guy called Spike Milligan. Smiling is infectious. You can catch it like the flu. When someone smiled at me today, I started smiling too. I walked around the corner when someone saw me grin. When he smiled, I realised I'd passed it on to him. I thought about the smile and then realised its worth. A single smile like mine could travel around the earth. So if you feel a smile begin, don't leave it undetected. Start an epidemic and get the world infected. Mr. Bennett loves an ode. He says them all the time. And he is my first special guest to share some words that rhyme.
Poetry Corner special guest.
This week's poem is from Don't Put Mustard in the Custard by Michael Rosen and Quinton Blake. And it is called Don't. Don't do that. Don't pull faces. Don't tease the cat. Don't pick your ears. Don't be rude at school. Who do they think I am? Some kind of fool? One day they'll say, don't put toffee in my coffee. Don't pour gravy on the baby. Don't put beer in his ear. Don't stick your toes up his nose. Don't put confetti on the spaghetti. And don't squash peas on your knees. Don't put ants in your pants. And don't put mustard in the custard. Don't chuck jelly at the telly. Don't throw fruit at the computer. Don't throw fruit at the computer. Don't throw fruit at the computer. What do they think I am? Some kind of fool?
Poetry Corner!
I think I ought to warn you, we're off to Poetry Corner.
Sports day, and I have no doubt that you'll enjoy its rhymes and fun as penned by Winnie
Ferguson.
Sorry, I've just been out running. This one's called The Sports Day and it's by Winnie Ferguson. Sports day's here at last, hooray! I can't wait for my race. I've matching plimsolls, shorts and top and sun cream on my face. I've practiced egg and spoon at home and bouncing in a sack. Because last year did not go so well, and I was at the back. The teacher kindly cheered me on and said I'd done my best, but I had wanted medals to wear proudly on my chest. So this year, nothing's left to chance. I've spent my days in training, but what's all this? The forecast says the next 3 days it's raining, and now I'm stuck indoors instead, driving Mum insane. I would have been the sack race queen had it not been for the rain.
Poetry Corner!
Poetry Corner special guest.
Hey guys, Mrs. Clements is this week's guest to share a poem that she likes best.
So my poem is Eletelephony by Laura Elizabeth Richards. Once there was an elephant who tried to use the telephone. An elephant who tried to use the telephone. Dear me, I'm not certain quite that even now I've got it right. However it was, he got his trunk entangled in the telefunk. The more he tried to get it free, the louder buzzed the telefee. I fear I'd better drop the song, or elephop and telephone.
Mrs. Pupils.
I think I ought to warn you, we're off to Poetry Corner.
It's nearly the summer holidays and the last of our shows for a while, so I thought we'd try something different that will hopefully make you all smile. I asked my class to be poets and to write a few words they could share. Well, they rose to the challenge with gusto and roared out the words like a bear. And so, with my pride fully bursting and without any further ado, my first special guests are Andromeda with a poem they've written for you.
We have fun. We go to beach and swim in the sun.
We lay on the soft sand to dry, staring up at the beautiful blue sky.
We say each other
stories,
then we jump and have a nice
solo. Strawberry ice cream, mint chocolate too. We love ice cream and so do you.
Go to the beach and we do some clubbing. Snap, 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 and the clubs go grubbing.
When we're crab hunting, it's really hot and we have no school and we like it a lot.
The days are lazy and we relax. No maths, no science and we chillax.
Poetry Corner, special guest.
My next guest has tales of a dragon, a curious rhyme she will tell. So please make some noise, all you girls and you boys, as we welcome Miss Marcel.
There's a dragon in the classroom. Its body is a box. Its head's a plastic waste bin. Its eyes a broken clock. Its legs are cardboard tubes. Its claws are toilet rolls. Its tongue's my dad's old ties. That's why it's full of holes. Oh, what a lovely dragon, our teacher smiled and said. You are a pretty dragon, she laughed, ha ha ha, and stroked its head.
Oh, no I'm not,
it snorted. Snap, snap, it moved its jaws and chased our screaming teacher along the corridors.
Poetry Corner.
And now we have to say goodbye, the time has simply flown. But why not look for poems whilst you're 6 weeks off at home? Or even better, why not write some words yourself that rhyme? Who knows, you may be my next guest when we return next time. I hope your summer holiday is full of blissful fun. I wish you every happiness and buckets full of sun. I cannot wait to hear your tales once we get back to school. Keep happy, safe, I'm off to read some poems by the pool.
Poetry Corner!
Finish off our Omnibus show, we thought we'd record something extra. The first ode's about stringy pasta with a beautiful slimy texture. When Betty eats spaghetti, she slurps, 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 and when she's finished slurping, she burp, burp, burps. And this is the very first poem I ever did perform. I think it was back in January when Poetry Corner was born. It's a sweet little tale about snowballs and the time that I made a true friend. But things did not go as expected, especially not at the end. I made myself a snowball, as perfect as could be. I thought I'd keep it as a pet and let it sleep with me. I made it some pyjamas and a pillow for its head. But then last night it ran away, but first it wet the bed. To finish our Omnibus show, we thought we'd... to finish off...
right, sorry. Okay, it's a long day.
Sweet little tale about snowballs and the thing... Oh, that was going so well!
Everything was going
and
on.
The
just,
thing.
Just rewind.
Rewind. Okay. And this is the very first...
It's still going very well. Sorry.
Ready? I made myself.
Breakfast.
You really does choose them.
I really do. It's a, okay.
Should we do that again?